You know, let's see. Megan, come on, Megan, let's get the money. You know, in fact, when we're there, we're going to be able to learn how to earn so much money that you'll qualify for the Benz right away.
Okay.
No. Okay, so if Megan's not really a rent, though, she's a fun. But if I were to invite Megan and say, Megan, we're going to have so much fun together. In fact, there's going to be so many people there, and I know that you just love coming to events, and we're going to do a scavenger hunt. It's going to be a lot of fun. Would that be more your language?
I'll be at the front trying to
run
out of
life.
Anyways, what we're going to learn is who, and we're also going to learn who are you. Honestly, even going through this training again, I had a breakthrough myself, realizing that, you know, over the time, I had a little color change. So you guys will see what that's all about. I'm going to go ahead and there's four things I want to ask you guys. I want you just to pick one. So in your mind, I want you to be thinking about what really stands out to you first, what pops in your mind. Number one, money. Number two, meet people. Number three, meal packs. Number four, Moringa. 36 anti-inflammatories, 46 antioxidants, all your amino acids, even the 9-branched chain amino acids, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so you got those in your mind? Which word did you choose?
Meet people.
Who said that? Terry, meet people. What word did you choose? Meal packs. Where's our camera? I'm missing our camera. What word did you choose?
Moringa.
Moringa. Denise?
Meet people.
Moringa. Okay, so money, meet people, meal packs, Moringa. Moringa. Meet people.
Money.
Money. Money, 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 money. Money? Okay, awesome. For those of you that said money, stand up. So, why do people choose different things? Aren't we all here to make money? Right? Are we all here to make money?
Yes.
But look at the people that are standing up, right? So, how come everyone is not picking money if everybody has, you know, that as a mindset? It's because we all have different personalities. And we really have to learn to speak to that color and that personality, right? I mean, it's extremely, extremely important. So, I know that this isn't true because we're all winners, but I'm gonna speak to the reds in the room. Only two of you are gonna go diamond. Okay, who in their mind right now is saying, I'm gonna be that one, start sizing up everybody else? I'm gonna be one. Right? These are your reds. Okay, go ahead and sit down, thank you. Can you play some music for me? Just really loud music. Just take a second. Take loud music. Would have stood up and danced.
Megan.
I told you she was a blue, that's why. Anybody else would have stood up and danced? Okay.
Why didn't you?
Yeah.
I was trying to push my chair.
Oh, I love that. So, Megan is a certain color and personality that just wants to have fun. She's going to bring a party to the room. I mean, this is why she got asked to MC. This is who Megan is. Now, some of you are sitting here in the room going, I would never do that. Someone's going to watch me dance. I am not the person who's going to be dancing. I'm going to be sitting in the back of the room and yada, yada, and you'll find out who you are in a minute. But right now, raise your hand if you purchased a meal pack.
Which one?
Good.
We
can't
do it. I tried.
You can ring out corporate and do it over the phone.
Okay, if you could do it, who would buy a meal pack? Help me out here. Okay, would you buy one pack?
No.
Would you buy two packs?
No. More.
Would you buy three packs?
No. More.
Awesome. I love it. So, you guys are the people that really have a heart for giving to charity. You truly want to help people. And so keep that tucked in your brain, or you're going to find out who you are in a second here. Okay, so can we play music one more time?
Yes.
Oh, we're going to dance.
I'm not dancing. Anybody feel like that?
No.
Anyone want to just kind of sit back and not be a part of any of that? Yeah. Right? Okay. You know you're out there, and that's okay. Because we're going to learn how to speak to everybody. I mean, in your mind right now, you're thinking, okay, that is extremely awkward. I'm just not doing that. They play that music again, like in your mind already, you're thinking, if they play that music again, I'm rebelling, I'm not going to get up and dance, okay? So, super fun, and you're going to really enjoy what this all means, and I'm going to take this thing turned over here. So, those are the greens, and that when they sit back, they're more project-minded, oriented. They want to really take the time to understand something, figure it out first before they just jump in and do it, and so that's why they hesitate, and why is this not going? Here we go. So I'm going to help you guys identify yourselves. Would that be okay?
Yes.
Okay. So I want everybody to understand that if you're not speaking that right language to that color, you have to really know that they're not going to understand what you're truly trying to say. And you've got something tucked away in your mind, and you're really just kind of thinking, okay, why are they just not getting this? It's because we need to take the time to understand who each other are. So let's get into some of the details. So the Reds, who are the Reds? They're natural born leaders, they're independent. They're Belinda Byfield, she's gonna pioneer this area and she's gonna freaking crush it. They're goal oriented, they establish and they achieve goals. They see the whole picture. Your Reds are your visionaries, you need them in your business. They delegate, they're well organized. In fact, this is so funny. If you ask a Red, again, raise your hand if you're a Red. Okay, are you organized? Are you organized?
Sometimes.
Okay, all your Reds will deny they're organized, but their friends will tell them they are organized. It's just the way it is. Okay, so we've got the Greens. Your Greens are your perfect melancholies. They're very creative, they're analytical. They're serious, they're perfectionists. They avoid causing any kind of attention. That's why they're not going to be getting up and dancing. They're content to stay in the background. They're content to just, you know, be alone. If you're a Green, put your hand up. Are you on Facebook? Is it a struggle for you to be on Facebook? No? Okay, so you probably had to learn. Because most of your Greens, you're not going to find them on Facebook. They just don't want to be there. So Blues. They're fun to be around. They're storytellers. They live in the present. They have lots of energy and enthusiasm. Right, Megan? They love to inspire others. They're the life of the party. They're a center of attention. And then you have your Yellows. I love the Yellows. They're patient. They're quiet. We need Yellows in our business because they're the ones that they avoid conflict. They keep the peace. They're good listeners. They always have a lot of friends. Their Facebook is maxed out. They're easygoing, but they hide their emotions. FYI. So, have you guys figured out who you are now?
Yeah.
Everybody have an idea? The reality is, you're going to see that you're a little more one.
Yellows, you can't yell at because they just hold back.
They hold back.
You can't yell at yellows.
So, I'm going to tell you something.
Red spin first.
You can't be a red and a yellow. They're opposite. But you may be a little red and a little green, or a little red and a little blue, or a little yellow and a blue, or a little yellow and green.
Yeah.
So kind of be in your mind what you're most like. Okay, fantastic. So, what are your strengths? Because you need to know, again, how to talk to people. So the strengths because you need to know how to talk to people, everyone has to really identify who they are. And the next thing is to identify actually the challenges when you do know who you are. So the challenges, if you are a Red, it's gonna look like this. So you've identified and now you know that you're a Red. You're gonna be bossy, you're a little inflexible, right? Anybody agree with us?
Yes.
You're impatient, you're low on empathy. You're too busy for people. It's like, oh, they don't wanna do it, next. You're more interested in achieving goals, okay? Here's your challenges, but let me tell you, These challenges are not necessarily weaknesses. They're, once they're identified and you know that it's a weakness, now it's an opportunity to turn it into a strength, okay? Because you're gonna have to learn to be a chameleon so you can really talk to people. So you gotta understand this. Your reds are argumentative, they're very domineering. They believe they're yellow. They think they're so fun, they just think they're yellows. It's kind of funny. So when they need an objection, typically a red is gonna be like, game on. That's just kind of their attitude. So if you're blue, you're impatient. You're chronically late. You like to say things like, well, I'm late, but I'm worth the wait. You're compulsive talkers. Squirrel. You're just easily distracted as well. You're forgetful. You like to exaggerate a lot. Poor listener. I mean, truly, you can be talking to a blue, and they are so already thinking about what they're going to say next, or I'm listening to you just so they know what they're going to say next. That's a blue if you struggle with that. They also have a very lack of follow through. Like, they're not going to be, they'll like to start the projects, but they don't want to finish the projects. And when met with an objection, what do you think a blue's going to do? Anybody?
It's not their fault.
They're going to quit. Your blues are going to quit. So if you're yellow, you're shy, kind of like what Denise hit on. But you're very, well, I guess another something that's challenging for you is you're indecisive. It takes a little bit for you to really, you know, go after your goals. Your yellows really aren't very goal-oriented either. They're stubborn. They're very sarcastic and they have a fear of change. So that's a huge challenge for them. What do you think if a yellow has an objection come at them, how are they gonna handle it?
Shut down.
Yep, it can't be done. Why should I even try? That's your yellow, good job. So if you're green, before you do anything, you have to figure it all out. These are your people that really have to do the research of the research of the research. And then when they research, they finally might get back to you after they do a little more research. That's your green. Are you a green? Look at her wearing that green tie. So they're too cautious. They're procrastinators as well. They're perfectionists. Your greens also, it's just, they have a hard time. It's difficult for them to be in social environments. They're going to be your introverts. They're going to feel very awkward in social situations. So what do you think if they get met with an objection? How are they going to handle it? Well, they're going to regret all the time they spend analyzing it. So they have some regret issues that, you know, they will struggle with. But isn't that interesting? Isn't it fun to kind of know maybe where you're falling into? What do you guys think my primary color is?
Red.
Red, blue. Good job. I thought it was a red, yellow. So super fun. So it's gonna be really important for you to understand how to relate to them, right? So now that you've identified yourself and we've gone through some of those challenges, how do you think this can help you when you're identifying the colors when you're prospecting? Yeah, and what would it possibly look like when you're prospecting? So if you're prospecting a red person, let me ask you this, what do you think a red person's Facebook might look like?
Organized.
No, you're red. Business life. You might have events on there. You have money. You might have beach scenes. They'll be the ones that will be telling people how to do stuff because they chose to do it. So you just better join or get off the page. That's red.
I like it.
What else do you guys think that they would do? They're also going to be your motivators, though. They're going to have a lot of quotes and motivation on there. They're going to be, they're going to be black and white too. You're not going to see a lot of long posts from reds on Facebook. That's not going to be them. What about a blue? What do you think, how would they look on Facebook?
Fun.
All over the place.
They're the ones with most of selfies. Yeah, they'll be the first one to put up their hand and go do things. Like I said, their Facebook will be maxed out. They'll have all their friends just maxed on Facebook.
Posts that go for pages.
What's that?
Posts that go for pages.
Yeah, for pages.
You got to hit the continue reading thing to get all the way through.
And do you know any blues on Facebook? Exactly. You always got to hit the more button on the blue.
Yeah.
How about yellows?
No, not really.
So they're on Facebook, and what do you think that it would look like? I mean, they're going to be talking about all the things that are wrong in the world and how they can fix it. What about if it's their birthday? They're going to be the one that says, click the charity button and give.
Yeah.
Right? What else?
They just share stuff on yellow, so they put themselves on there. They're either tagging something or they just share something.
Yeah, they do get excited. They do share a lot. How about greens? What do you think their page would look like? Nothing, because they're not on Facebook. They just, that's something that's really difficult for them, you know? They, again, they're the ones that are just that social awkward. So to be on Facebook social media is not, you know, something that they want to do. But it's all necessary. Because what we really need to understand as we're looking at our colors here is what attracts certain colors, let's talk about Tzeesia. What might that be? If a red. So if you're talking to a red and we're relating it to our business, how could you attract a red? How would you invite them?
Comp plan.
Oh my goodness. Yes. Belle, you've got to come and check this out. I got so excited when I saw this compensation plan. It blew my mind. I've never seen a comp plan that's not watered down and actually, you know, pays people fairly forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. That's why I would invite her. But if I would say, Belle, you've got to see our Miracle Foundation, and you gotta check out the meal packs. We're gonna help a lot of people. It's not that she doesn't like those things. It's not gonna speak to her. I'm gonna get her to the event if I talk about comp plan first. Because see, she's already got it figured out. She knows if she can make money, she can help a lot of people.
Yeah.
And that's the way she's gonna think. So that's the way you wanna lead with her. How else? And write these down. I mean, talk to your reds more goal-oriented. You know what? I'm really looking for some people that want to dig their heels in like I've dug in. I'm looking for someone that wants to commit for 3 years because we are going to do this big together. Mm-hmm. That would scare a green like, How else might you talk to a red or invite them to look at our opportunity? Team building?
Ranking?
Team building is more your blues. Mm-hmm. Come on, we're going to. Mm-hmm. Ranking. It's money, money, money. You can earn cars here. We have got the most ambitious team. We are really breaking records. That's the kind of stuff that's going to get a red excited. So how about a blue? How might you invite them?
Team spirit.
Team spirit. We have these big events every 90 days. Yeah. In between that, we have these team meetings. And once a year, we all get together. It's a big party. Your blue's going to want to show up. It's going to want to bring
results.
All those things. We have a cruise. You could, you know, have a chance. The success trips. How else might you think for a blue? We talked about the party part, but what your blue really wants to know, is there going to be people there? Am I going to make new friends? How many people? What kind of people? So it's the people. It's the travel. It's the fun. It's the trips. It's the incentives. It's the party. It's the collaboration. That's what is going to attract. So what could an invitation look like for someone to look at Tzeesia? What would you say if you were talking to a blue? So go ahead, stand up and say. Give me a whole, you can't just walk and say someone come to our events. How would you maybe present a whole?
Okay, if I was talking to a blue, I'd say you've got to come to Summit. We're going to Florida. We're going to book some trips. We might go to Hawaii on the way there. We're going to organize rooms and stuff. There'll be lots of people. I went last year. It was awesome. We had a lot of fun. We had a ball.
Nice.
The DJ was in the middle of the room. The room was
okay, are you a yellow? Or you're blue?
A little yellow? No, I'm red blue.
You're big blue. Okay. So do you notice the blue really came out of her? She wasn't going to stop inviting. dog. But you know what? That's perfect because she is a blue. We're asking about a blues. Blues attract blues. But guess what she really needs in her business? She needs some reds. So she's going to learn. Okay, so now you stand back up, Kim, and how would you invite a red being a blue? You're going to have to be a chameleon.
How about invite a red?
Yes.
Okay. If I was to invite a red, I'll say, you're a born leader. You've got potential. You know what it takes to make it big. You're sick and tired of all the shit that you're going through. Susan, I'm not even.
Okay, now get the invitation. You said like it's
a... Oh, you've got to come over. You've got the opportunity to bring a team over with you and lead them. Do something for your
Okay,
people.
Now invite them. You're telling them what to do. You still need to invite.
Okay. Let's do you've it. Got to come.
You're still told them what to do. So this is an important thing, but this is really good. Will you come? Will you join me? It has to be an opportunity at some point that you've asked. But that was excellent. So thank you, Kim. Give her a hand. She did something else naturally that was amazing because she's had a lot of amazing trainees. She complimented the Red first. You've got to compliment them first. You have to say, this is what I see in you. You have so much potential to be a leader that we're looking for, and I really would love for you to be a part of my organization. But at some point, you cannot tell Red what to do. They will rebel against you. So you cannot say all these compliments. This is for you. You're going to love it. This and that. Just come. They'll be like, well, but what an amazing exercise that was, right? So we had a blue invite a blue, and so that was natural and easy for her. But when we asked her as a blue to be a chameleon for a minute and invite a red, because the blues need reds in their team, that was a little more challenging. Honestly, she like killed it though. Yeah. I'm gonna be honest with you. She did something very natural. But at the same point, I think all personalities struggle with one particular thing because we just love what we do. We don't stop and breathe for a second and actually give them the opportunity to decide to answer the question that they want to be a part of it and join us. We tell people a lot of time what to do, which is bottom-down goal setting, and you can't do that because the way you bring them in is the way you have to keep them in. And if you told them to come in, you're gonna have to tell them they gotta stay. So just be mindful, you know, get excited, do your thing, do your invitation for whomever you need to do it, but take a breath a minute and say, what do you think? Will you join me? What do you think? Will you come? What do you think? Can you come to this event? Can you clear your calendar? Can you do anything humanly possible to make sure that you show up? Can you do that? And you gotta zip it, you gotta let them answer it. So does anyone kind of think maybe they've struggled with that in the past? That doesn't come as naturally sometimes because we're so excited? Yes, Ian?
If they're talking to Blue and they don't shut up, how do you get wordy? If you're talking to a blue and they won't shut up, how do you get a word in?
No. Well, if they're talking to a blue, they'll just talk all over each other and they'll be so happy they'll just both go anyways. It's just kind of the way it works out. Okay, so if you're a yellow, how would you invite a yellow? Go ahead. If you're yellow, please stand up. Okay, awesome. Got a yellow. So Denise will let. Okay, so how would you invite a yellow, being a yellow, to the opportunity to an event,
say there's an opportunity to help animals, and you will, part of your money that goes to Zesia is helping people.
Yes.
That's what I would say.
Right, now where's the invitation? Okay, now stop, 1 second, this is a very good example. A lot of you will say exactly that, and you'll think they'll just throw their credit card at you or sign themselves up to go to the event. She still hasn't invited them to come.
No,
she spoke their language. They liked what they heard, but people want to be—they want to feel wanted.
I have to say, I want you on my team because you personify the what we want.
And now say, will you join me? Will you come?
You join me.
Yes, perfect. Awesome. Good job. Thanks, Denise. So, stay standing. You're yellow. How would you invite a blue?
Party, baby.
Where's the whole invitation? You can't just walk up to someone and say, party, baby.
Can I just say, Sharon Carter does the best home events ever.
Mostly, I said, talking to somebody that I sort of know would go like the party route, hey, you know I'm doing this, I love helping people, and this is my thing, but come join me, because you know I like to get up on the stage with you. Come join me.
Awesome, so will you come join me? Come join me is still a command. Okay. You guys gotta listen to your words a little bit. You can't be just throwing out commands. I mean, you can, but you won't get the best results. So, awesome, I love it. So, do you have a lot of blues in your team?
Yes.
She's the best hostess, she throws the parties, she knows how to invite to parties. Now she has to learn how to speak the money language so she can get some leaders. How about a green? How'd you invite the green to the event or to conference?
If the conviction, so I would actually say, what you're doing is perfect, but you need to maybe turn it over a little bit.
Okay, so let me go ahead.
I would introduce them to the research of it.
Yes. Oh my gosh, you've got to come to the summit. Our whole scientific team is there. We're going to be breaking everything down. You're going to hear, you're going to want to take a ton of notes, bring that special iPad you have so you can take all these notes. And during the breaks, we get to go in and actually spend some time with the scientists. We're going to see all the new products. You'll get to see the latest, the greatest, the ingredients. Wait till you hear.
That's
the
one. Meet the people who have started the Miracle Foundation.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Meet people that started the Miracle Foundation.
Because the Greens are the givers, and they want to buy the meal packs.
That's the yellows. Your greens are your overly analytical. Your greens are, okay, how long has this company been around? It's been 10 years. Who owns the company? What's the track record of the company? I really have to understand, you know, what the success is. They're the ones, too. They're going to be like, okay, it's MLM thing. So is it a really billion-dollar industry? Like, can you show me the facts on that? Yes. Go ahead.
I'd actually offer to, in some way, help with the details and to be there for them and that sort of thing, so that you're leading
they
them.
They have to know that things are worked out.
Yep. So that you're leading them and you're not, and they're confident enough to go with you then.
Exactly. So we're being really specific to like a true green or a true red, and just know that most people are not just the ones. And typically, if somebody is everything, they're in denial. You can't be everything. Yes?
It can be, for me, I'm like, say, melancholy at home, but once I get out in the workforce doing my job, I'm already.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Because she's learned to adapt.
Different in different situations. Yeah.
But there are greens at home that still go to the workforce and refuse to adapt. And they act like greens in the workforce. So she's absolutely right. So there's going to be the different hats that you wear that you're going to dig deep and you're going to be who you need to become so that you get the job done. But this introvert can't wait to go home, kick off her shoes. She's not going out to party at night. She's going home to chill and read her books. So, but she knows what she has to do in order to be successful. This is why Belle hit the nail on the head when we're talking about personal development. From her being shy, not wanting to the grocery store, to now her being a network marketing rock star, a social media queen, which is totally opposite spectrums.
Yeah.
You have to personally develop. Why would you want to stay exactly where you are? Unless you're just exactly satisfied with everything that you have. But then if you've got children in your life, or people that are close to you, or family or friends, isn't it interesting how we can look at the ones that we love that are near us, and we can just say and think that, man, I wish they would just get out of their shell. I wish they would learn how to appreciate this, or, you know, you start seeing these things in other people, right? Hold on one second. And if you see that in other people, you can't have conversations with them if you're not willing to be the change yourself. Because that is what's so important, is to show people. That's why I say we're not in the telling business, we're in the show business. It's time to show who you are, to show who we are as a team, to show what you're capable of because of the gifts we have with this company, with these products, and the distribution. Yes, Denise?
I met a man that, he was a really red personality. He was go, get, do. It was really, really, he was really a powerful red. And he didn't know his little girl was yellow. And he was yelling and screaming all over, that's what he was telling Dad that before him. And the little yellow person, she kept pulling back from him. And he finally figured out that she was yellow.
Oh.
So he'd been yelling at her, like, get it done, do this, do something else. And she'd be going back to the little shell, you know?
Awesome. Well, and it's nice when you learn to recognize something, but you got to get into action and recognize it, and then you got to make changes. So let me ask you this. Pardon me?
Can I just add something?
Yes.
In saying what I said before, it was very good for my personal development because I'd come home and relax. And this is an at-home business.
Right.
So I realised that I needed to set up an area in my house which was business so that I would turn into a red when I was at home. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you guys hear that? It just gives me goosebumps. So again, she recognised and she took action on how to course correct and do what she needed to do. This is why we need to love on each other and show who we are and continue to grow and come to events. Who just feels like that was a huge aha moment for them because they're agreeing? This is what happens when we do come together. We hear things like this. Okay, so let me do this. Let me ask you guys some questions, and I want you to tell me what color of a person would this be about. What is the makeup of the proprietary blend? Who would ask you that?
Green.
Exactly. How do you make money?
Green.
How fast can you make money?
Red.
Who's the number one income earner in your company?
Red.
Sorry, I'm a red. How does the pay plan work?
Green.
Immediately, they just start talking about helping people when you're trying to talk to them. I mean, they're talking about their, Aunt Becky and their sister-in-law.
Blue.
Yellow. Can I get a BMW instead of a Benz?
Red.
You want to know the funny thing about the red, kind of like what I said with Belinda, they are already assuming they're going to get the car, and they want a different one. What about the question of, I think the market's just saturated?
Always, they've got the best clothes on, their vest and their best shoes on.
They're put together. So what about the question, is the market saturated? I just hear that there's Asia everywhere.
Green.
Who else is doing this?
Blue.
That's blue. They want to know who else is doing it. How much money do you make?
Green.
No, that's a red. So be bold enough to ask you that. More than you are making in this company. That's good. Write that down. How do you host events? Who would ask you? How do you host events? That's your blue. Okay, do I need to just go back to the beginning of this presentation? What are the meal packs, and what's this whole Miracle Foundation all about?
Yellow. Mm-hmm.
Okay, someone throw out a green question. What might a green ask you?
Who's the scientist?
What's the ingredients?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Those
what's
are the,
in it?
Yeah, what's in it? What about a red? Throw out another red question.
How much money?
What's a different one that maybe we haven't spoken about?
How do we get to the top?
You know what? They're the ones that are going to be asking those how questions that we really want.
Is
that
a network marketing?
No. Reds. Most reds are about making money and they know it does work. They're not the ones that are going to say, is it network marketing?
No,
those are going to be more your pessimists.
No
No. It's you guys are coming up with the red question. So give me a yellow question. What might a yellow ask you? What have you been asked by a yellow? Sure, yeah, they will get into that more. I had one of our younger generation, one of our millennial gals on the team. She did this killer, she's like doing lots on Snapchat, doing really good, and she'll do it on Facebook too, but one of her things was, if I could help you make money by feeding the world, would you join me?
Wow.
She spoke to a lot of yellows. She got hit up, I think she rolled 7 people that week.
Wow.
And she's just selling one to multiple meal packs and helping people get started that way. But anyway, so good. So how do you think this can help you when you are identifying the colors of your team? Would that be pretty beneficial? You already got people in y'all have a team? More than one person that you've invited to join you?
Yeah.
Okay, one more time. Do y'all have a team?
Yes.
Okay, cool. So if you have a team and you're speaking to a red and you're mentoring them, how are you getting a red? How are you talking to your red that's a team member?
Can I introduce you to Belinda Byfield?
They're going to want to speak to, they don't want to speak to you, they want to speak to the person above you. That's what I did to Kevin. It's really nice. I'm letting you know that I want to do this now, but I need to talk to your VP or CEO quick. how else? Remember what I said earlier that Kim did naturally? It's appreciation. Your reds like to be appreciated. So you know what, Belinda, you're doing such an amazing job on our team. In fact, at the next quarterly team destination event, I would love for you to host it. Would that be something that you'd be willing to do? Because I know you're just going to crush it.
Yes.
That's the way you'd want to talk to a red. But what I couldn't do that opposite of any other color with Belinda. Now we're going to have a lot of details. And in fact, I need you to manage all the details from the time we get started to the time we're done,
right,
and make sure this and this and this, exactly, it's agreeing. But Belinda's gonna be like, I am not signing up for that. That is not happening. But how else are you gonna be able to motivate your blue, I mean your red?
You power them up, like they already know that they're good. So you applaud them.
Mm-hmm.
Set some
you
challenges.
Tell them their strengths,
yeah,
and goals. Plans,
And you know, you give them some responsibility a little earlier. Don't give your greens any responsibility. They don't want that. Your reds are gonna want that. Look at, so their strengths, their closers, and their desires to have control. And this is why I said, you know, you've got the extrovert and the optimism. This is why a red can't be yellow too, really, because it's totally opposite. Here, in here, yeah, oh, go ahead and take a picture. Who thinks if you knew about some of these colors before this event, you would have had more people here? Do you guys think that you could have had more people come?
Will Bench has got a thing that's called the color match.
Mm-hmm.
And it's done by a guy named Will Bench.
So you really need to understand who your team members are so you can talk to them in a way that you're motivating them. If you're not talking to them in the way that's going to motivate them, you're going to lose them. They're slowly going to drift.
Look at him in the way that was yummy, so it's huge drinking.
Well, let's do this and stay on track here. So when we're speaking about motivating your team and you're looking at these different colors, what I would do as you're looking at your team, I would make sure your blues know who your blues are and introduce them. They need to know who they are because they're gonna keep the team together. They're gonna make sure that you guys are having events, they start on time, all that kind of stuff, right? One of the things I would do with your reds on your team, they love competitions. Oh my goodness, Terry is about to outrank you, Belinda. I'm not sure if you're gonna be okay with that, but I know that you have it within you. So what do you think about doing a little challenge right now? Would that be something you want to participate in?
Hell yes.
See? That's awesome. But do you see how I first gave her a compliment? And then I said I pit her against a little bit in a friendly competition. And then I went back. I still asked her if that's something she wants to do. This is a volunteer army, guys. Be careful not to tell people what to do, because it doesn't matter what color they are, they will walk away from you at some point.
You said exactly the same thing as to Terry, didn't you?
What's that?
That bell's about to beat her.
Oh, that I could say the same thing back to her. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a thought process going on in my head too.
Yeah.
We can feel it. We can feel it.
So hopefully you guys have taken a lot of notes here. I want to give you a little bit of an activity and a challenge. I want you, when you're prospecting now, you know, I talked about my rule when you're talking with people, 3 to 5 questions so you can gain intel. I want you to really identify the person as you are talking to them and ask at least 5 questions that would speak to their color. So it's going to be a little bit of a twist, but I think that you're really going to see that you're going to gain some results that are going to really help you qualify better. So 5 questions that would speak. I'm so sorry, I need to turn that thing off. Now, where this came from, a lot of this that I really love is Big Al Shriver, your personalities, 4 color personalities in network marketing, in MLM is actually the title. And it's on Audible. And it would really be a good idea to let your family members, especially the ones you live with, be a part of this. Have them read the book. Have your kids be a part of it and read the book. Now you don't want to go nuts and start walking around. There's a red, there's a blue, there's a yellow. You can just see like the 8-year-old, right? But we have to have this as a life skill. Wouldn't it have been fantastic if we were taught this in school?
Yes.
We end up going to work in our cubicles or whatever, butting heads with people because we just don't understand people. And what an easy way to be able to have, you know, a tool to create some communication that's effective. I mean, I don't know if you're me, but you could probably even be looking at any relationships you've had in the past and go, holy cow, I totally screwed that up. That was a green. I want that green back in my life. I need to go back and I need to, you know, rework through a few things. But then when you have these conversations, they're going to be very conducive to creating a very harmonious relationship. Yes?
What was the name of the book you mentioned before?
Big Al is the author, which Big Al has a ton of great books. And it is Four Color Personalities in MLM. It should pop up if you do something like that.
So how would you, watching this, there's a few customers of mine that I know that looking at this, I have used the wrong language.
Mm-hmm.
How would you go back to them?
So you're a red?
I'm definitely half red, half blue.
Half red, blue. So you and I, we're sisters. So I have railroaded some people, and I think I'm such a friendly driver. But yes, there will be some people I would have to even go back myself and just say, have the opportunity. You know, let me think. So Carrie, I just have to tell you something. I totally missed something. When I was speaking with you, I was talking about, you know, some of the incentives that were coming up, but you got to know about a few other things I think will really speak to your heart. Will you give me a minute to share something with you?
Mm-hmm.
Break down the meal pack, tell them about the Miracle Foundation.
Apology.
I don't need to apologize now, my personality. I need to reapproach them.
Right. Now, this isn't an apology of your personality. This is an apology of the action that you particularly took. Because trust me, I don't believe in saying sorry for no reason. There's no reason to be sorry for anything, really. Sorry, that's my red coming out. But if I know that I offended somebody, like you just admitted, they are not participating like they could. Right. But you know what I mean. There's an adjustment that can make, and because you're not talking about a red that you made a mistake with, you're going to want to speak to their language, and if you've got a yellow, man, I totally missed the boat on something. You've got to know this. To me, that's not an apology. That's recognizing that I didn't speak to you in the right language. Will you give me another minute? Because you got to know what's going on. If you miss this, you may not like me.
Yeah.
Do you have a few minutes?
I think I've missed a yellow.
Mm-hmm.
Was asking about like the meal plans and all that sort of stuff, but then I talked quite business orientated to it. So, you know, I could definitely go back to that girl. We're obviously still friends, it's not
issue. Right, no, of course.
But she didn't come.
What we're talking about upper level mindset. Most people will not take the time to do this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. You can go through, I highly suggest this. I would go to your back office. I would click in the the manager of your team, team manager, and I would click on all your personals. I would really look at that, and after this event, I would give them a quick note, call, text message, something, give them a quick touch, and touch them in the way that you know who they are. Start practicing. And then I would also look at your Builder 500s, if you have Builder 500s, and I would start sticking to them like glue. And then I would really fine-tune the way you work with them according to who they are and not who we are. It's a very hard, difficult thing to do. Because why? Because it comes naturally to us to be who we are.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I'm not saying don't be who you are. You know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But to talk to them in a way that we only understand, and that's just not a good idea. It's just kind of selfish, really. Because then you're thinking, well, I don't care. I just want who, you know, ever, whatever, because of the way I do things. And then what you have is a team of reds, button heads, and nobody likes each other, and they're splitting off, and nobody's doing anything in sync.
Mm-hmm.
Yes?
So what's the perfect team makeup?
All of them.
Okay, well, yes and no. So you want a lot of blues on your team. You need some reds. You need everybody, but I will tell you, in network marketing, you need a lot of blues.
Yeah, like, so when we probably all want to know.
You'll have a big team if you have a lot of blues. Because guess what? You don't need that many reds. Not everyone's going to be a leader.
So a few reds, many blues.
Pardon me? No. If you're needy
blues.
She's green. She wants the formula.
Are you green?
That's a good point. Because this has confused me as to.
Oh, she's so green. This is too much information. She did not give me the right details. It's not making sense. And you may not be thinking all of those things. But this does take a while. I remember the first time I heard the personalities. Oh, what did you say? Am I right? Okay. I just didn't want to tell you.
Lots of blues.
But here's the reality. This is not anything we're used to. When we are born, we're all about me. Give me that. I want this. You know what I mean? It's just the first language. You don't have to teach a child how to take care of themselves. You have to teach them how to play nice and not hit others, right? Mm-hmm. Or take toys. But my point is, you know, you've got your melancholy, your sanguines, you've got, you know, your colorics, you've got your dogs, your beavers, your otters, you've got your reds, blues, yellows, your squiggles, your straight lines. My point is there's lots of ways to teach personalities, and if this is the first time you're seeing it, it is overwhelming. The only thing you're really going to understand is the things that speak to you and your color or your squiggle or your, you know, melancholy, whatever your personality is. That's what's going to make the most sense to you right now. So I grab that book, give yourself time and patience, and just, you know, how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. And then just start playing with it, though. You know, invest in yourself, I-L-T. You invested to come to this event. And you're going to invest time to then learn the language, that's the L, invest, learn, and then you need to turn around and teach it and use it right away. It's the best way to be able to keep it, what you've done. So, thank you guys very much. I appreciate you, and I hope that this has been valuable.
Yes.
And just, you know,
yes.
Keep on keeping on. Thanks, guys. Woo-hoo.